弟兄姐妹们早。
早。
弟兄姐妹们早。早。今天有我弟兄姐妹春去的人跟他说早。
早。
今天早上要起床这样子。OK。很高兴我可以在这边分享神的话。我叫做 Andy。I'm one of the pastors of the congregation. I serve alongside of Pastor Benjamin, who is currently still out of the country right now. So remember to pray for him.I'm really excited to share God's word, but at the same time, which is still nervous every time I have to preach, I'm still very nervous. 而且今天早上在第一堂讲完，然后I preach a different message, and 我到现在已经有点没有力了。But please keep in your prayer. 如果说我语无伦次的话 ，just kind of like, hey, good job, okay? So keep in your prayers as I share God's word today.
我们今天要看的一个 passage, our passage is at Genesis 25. So would you turn your Bibles to Genesis 25 with me?
And if you don't have a Bible, go ahead and raise your hand. I'll usher your hand to a Bible. You will need your Bible today. Genesis 25, verse 19. Genesis 25, verse 19.
创世纪二十五十九。
If you have it, say,I have it.
I have it.
Okay, 就他们得先讲了。还有没有圣经的可以请举手，还是会请，follow on. Genesis 25:19. If you have it, say I have it.
All
right, go ahead and put it down real quick. 这边有弟兄姐妹的人，可不可以请你举手一下？举手。你要是有弟兄姐妹的话，请你举手，举高一点点，举高一点点。OK, 好 ，wait real quick. 好 ，here's down. 那如果说你有被你的弟兄姐妹欺负过了，请你举手一下，举高高，然后 wave 一下，好 wave 一下 ，OK 那。那有谁 still 马上我一讲那个，你可以 remember something 然后 I'm so angry 我有一个哥哥，那 some of you don't know that I actually have a brother， 然后他比我大三岁半，那比我高，从小就比我高，然后从小就。比我壮一点，然后我比较笨，我从小我就喜欢吃我喜欢吃比较那种比较不好吃的菜啊，或者是蛋白啊，那他就比较喜欢吃肉啊，然后蛋黄啊，所以我就把蛋剥开的时候，我就把蛋白吃掉，然后把蛋黄给他，然后他就很高兴，然后我也很高兴，就他就越来越大只，然后变成我就被欺负嘛。那从小的时候，他很喜欢欺负我，玩电动的时候呢，就是我们玩电动嘛，然后呢，就是之前玩那个 Street Fighter 啊。一个人打这边，然后另外一个人打这边，对不对？然后呢，他就总是会用相扑那一只。OK， 如果说你们用 Street Fighter 那一只哦，那相扑那一只呢特别烦，因为他有一招是那种啪啪啪啪这样的。OK， 然后你的手一直动的时候呢，我不是很会玩，但他很有经验的嘛，对不对？那我就试着要挡，可是你那一招其实是挡不住的，对不对？就一直被打，然后他就把我打到那个 corner。然后呢，他就很高兴，对不对？我没办法 do anything， 然后我跳也跳不起来啊什么的，对，他就同样一招，就啊，他一直用我，然后我就哦，然后就死掉了，然后他就在那边笑得很开心，哈、啊，我又赢了，对不对？然后他说要不要再玩一次？我说好，再换一次，然后我就换另外一个人，结果呢，他又用相扑，然后就一直用同样一招，那我们叫这一招叫做不好的招式，对不对？所以他就一直用这一招，然后就一直欺负我，那我们。有些字在那边不能讲。那 OK， 那这是我们小的时候。那稍微大一点的时候呢，他欺负我就变严重了。他欺负我就是我去游泳。然后呢，我爸妈可能没有在看的时候，我就跟他去游泳了。然后他就会用水一直泼我，你知道用水这样子。那我又比他小的时候，我又挡不住，我又游不走，因为他就是游，我到哪里他就到那边，一直泼，然后我就不能呼吸，然后就很痛苦。然后直到有一次，他真的超过分了，他就游到 ，Are we recording this? Oh, OK, 爱哥哥，所以游到，他就游到那个游泳池最深的地方的话呢，那边有一个 ledge， 对，然后他就是把手放在上面，所以他的脚是里面是可能是 9 feet， 然后他说 ，I'll be glad， 然后就干嘛，他就游过去，他就抓住我的手 ，OK, I'm in the middle of the water 9 feet deep, OK, 然后呢，我就在那边游，他说，他会送给我。然后呢，他就把我的手往下沉 ，I have no place to 用力，然后就往上，我一点都不好玩的嘛，然后之后我就打他，然后呢，我就把他的那个手表，他之前很喜欢一只手表 G Shock， 我就把他的手表藏起来，结果 爸藏在冬库。哇 ，OK， 所以就是基本上就是这样子的 relationship 这样长大 ，OK， 他打我，他欺负我，我打回去，然后还是被打，对不对？那就是我就是这样子的长大，就是被家里面的情况。那其实 on top of that， 就是我 family 有 you know what 啊？那 every family has its issues， you know me and my brother or your parents， you know you and your sister or your cousins， but not every family has issues。Now some issues are huge， 真的是很大，你没办法 get rid of it， it's huge， you don't know what to do， and it bugs you almost on a daily basis because these are your family member， right？ These are issues in your family。 我们今天要看一个 scripture， 就是这个家庭里面呢，其实有很多很多的 issue。 They have so much issue， in fact there is so much issue that it drives them to God。 他们甚至不知道要怎么做，到一个地步他们需要来到面前，然后只能让上帝带。So would you turn with me in your Bibles, Genesis 25:19. 创世记 25:19. This is the account of Abraham's son Isaac. Abraham became the father of Isaac, and Isaac was 40 years old when he married Rebecca. For some reason, whatever you prefer, so it's called Reebok. Rebecca, daughter of Bethuel, the Aramean from Padan Aram, and sister of Laban the Aramean. 所以在这边 ，you notice 一开始他就讲说 ，this is the account of Abraham's son Isaac. 所以呢 ，one theory of 我们怎么样有 Genesis is that there are many different patriarchs, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. They write their own account. 有点像他们的日记 of what happened in their life.And an author, most likely Moses, put it all together. Okay, so right here it is Isaac doing the writing. He said, "This is my account. This is my story." Okay, and what he says is Abraham became the father of Isaac, and Isaac, verse 20, was 40 years old when he married Rebecca. 他的太太叫做 Rebecca, and specifically, 他还 go into 他的爸爸是 Bethuel, the Aramean, from Padan Aram, and the sister of Laban.Now, if you know your Bible, you know Laban is a character that's 喜欢有点占小便宜 kind of scheme you a little bit, kind of trying to get you to give up more of your rights, 然后想办法攀你的东西。所以 Rebecca is actually the sister of Laban, a character of such. Verse 21, Isaac prayed to the Lord on behalf of his wife because she was barren.The Lord answered his prayer, and his wife Rebecca became pregnant. Now, immediately after Isaac wrote his account, if I can have your attention, immediately after Isaac wrote his account, 他马上就说他的太太 Rebecca was barren, 不能有小孩子。And we have talked about this in previous sermons about kids. 就是 you cannot, 有些东西是 you can't buy with money, you can't do anything about it, 但是上帝不给你小孩子就不能有小孩子。And this was the case with Rebecca.And you have to know that this was not the only incident that has already happened. It had already happened to Isaac's father and Sarah. That is, they couldn't have a child until Abraham was 99, 100 years old. So the same problem was present in Isaac's life and in Isaac's marriage. So immediately as Isaac opens up his letter, he says, on behalf of his wife, she was barren, he prayed for her.Prayed for her. Now, 对这个家庭来说，没有小孩子 is a big issue. Because if they did not have children at that age, in that time, all their possessions, all the heritage from their parents, that is Abraham's family, that is, you know, they are rich. And all the possessions would go to a different family. All that they own would go to a maidservant's son.All that they own would have to go outside of the family. So it was against tradition, it was against culture to not have children. 那这样子的压力其实在 Rebecca 身上其实很重的。Rebecca 就是不能有小孩子怎么样？在 Isaac 的身上也是很重的。我们就是不能有小孩子，能怎么办？所以 the Bible says Isaac 这么大的事情，他到神的面前来，他祷告神。其实，在我们家庭当中，其实 this is the first incident that is recorded in his family.And in our family, there will be incidents that are big and that are so big that there's nothing you can do. It doesn't matter if you have money. It doesn't matter if you have power. It doesn't matter how hard you think it and scheme it and plan it out. There are things that
is too big for you. Just simply too big. And in your life as well. And so what Isaac did was, on behalf of his family, on behalf of the wife, he began to pray. And the Bible says, the Lord heard his prayer. The Lord heard his prayer. And she became pregnant. If you follow along with me, verse 22. The babies jostle each other within her. And she said, why is this happening to me? She went to inquire of the Lord. The Lord said to her, two nations are in your womb, and two people from within you will be separated. One people will be stronger than the other, and the older will serve the younger. Now, if I can have your attention, what happened here is Rebecca, being pregnant, had twins. But she doesn't know what's going on. 因为她两个小孩子在她的腹中。那我从来没有 pregnant 过，所以我 I'm only talking from what I imagine. 所以有两个小孩子在她的腹中，他们就开始打架。那她不可以去找个 MD， 然后照个 X 光，然后就知道 what's going on inside. She can't do that. 而且在里面她一直痛，一直打架。She doesn't know what's going on. 所以对她来说，她是很紧张的。会不会是 miscarriage？ 会不会是我有问题？会不会是有问题让这个小孩子出来怎么样？我需要知道为什么我的肚子一直在动，一直在打，一直在好不舒服的感觉。所以 the only person that she was able to go to, which is the best one, was God. 她到神面前来，她会说 ，Why is this happening to me? 为什么我的肚子这样子在打斗，在争，然后让我好不舒服 ？Why is this happening? And for you have to understand, for her it was a huge concern. 她好不容易得到小孩子了 ，if she is to miscarry this one.It would almost feel like it starts over again, that process, and she in some way is afraid. She wanted to know what's going on. So she comes before the Lord and goes, God, why is this happening to me? And God's answer was tremendous. God's answer has a lot of insights into our lives, not just in our family lives, but in our lives in general and in towards the future. This is what God says, verse 23, the Lord said to her,Two nations are in your womb, and two people from within you will be separated. One people will be stronger than the other, and the older will serve the younger. Now, what God said was huge. 因为上帝已经看到未来了，因为上帝已经知道这两个小孩子虽然在里面打架，上帝已经知道这两个小孩子以后会是什么样的情况。Think about it. 一个知道未来的神。是一个值得信赖的神，一个神他知道 what's going on 在你腹中的孩子 what's going on， he knows 是值得信赖的神，一个神他知道你孩子根本还没有出生，他就已经知道他们的未来会怎么样，他们的相处模式会怎么样，他们不但他们还没有生出来，他们生出来长大之后，他们的子子孙孙会是怎么样，一个人一个国比较大，另外一个老的会服侍小的，他上帝都已经知道这些 situation 了， and for me。That brings a lot of comfort. That is, I no longer have to worry about a lot of circumstances in my life. And I don't have to fight and strive to make things work. And God, what is your will in this? And because I know, 这些事情我还没有做之前，神就已经知道了。我都还没有开始做一些事情的时候，神就已经知道它的结果和它之后会发生的事情。甚至父母当还不知道小孩子还没有出生的时候，上帝已经知道他们出生会怎么样，他们长大会怎么样，他们的子子孙孙会怎么样。In fact, Jeremiah 1:5 says, "Before I formed you in your womb, before I knit you together in your mother's womb, I knew you." 你还没有在你妈的肚子里面的时候，你还没有被生出来的时候，你还没有长大的时候 ，I know you already. Before you were even in your mom's womb, God says, "I knew you. I knew you."And so this is the kind of confidence we can have in God. That God, first of all, knows us. 我们还没有做任何决定之前，我们还没有继续往前走的时候，上帝已经知道我们了。God knows us. When nobody else understands us, when nobody else knows us, when nobody trusts us, God says, I know you already. Before you were even born, you know what's coming. I knew you. And for the parents, it's the same thing. I mean,
I do two things for a living. I teach the word of God. It's my passion, and I serve in the church. And my other job is I'm a teacher. And many times I work with kids, and I see parents, I talk to parents, and a lot of parents are really stressed out. All stressed out all the time. And I think specifically for me, it was one of the most encouraging things when a parent actually said to me, the biblical concept of this, whether it be a parent or a 小组长, caring for the next generation of spiritual descendants, is that we are under shepherds of Christ. Sin, everything that we do actually belongs to God. And we are simply managers of what He has entrusted to us. And so that gives me tremendous comfort that God knows the future. That I don't have to, make it worse, but in reality, God already knows. And I can just follow what He has planned for me and for us. Verse 24. When the time came for her to give birth, 就是她要生产的时候, 她应该很紧张, there were twins in her womb. Verse 25. The first to come out was red. The first to come out was red, and his whole body was like a hairy garment. So they named him Esau, which means hairy. Wow, I would hate to be the elder son. The first to come out was red, and he was hairy, and they named him Esau, which means hairy. Okay, it's a sad kid, right? Verse 26. After this, his brother came out with his hands grasping Esau's heel. So he was named Jacob, which means deceiver or heel grabber. Isaac was 60 years old when Rebekah gave birth to him. Now, for this next illustration, I'm going to ask my good buddy, the worship leader, Miles. Is he around? He is.我很庆幸能够，我们其实一起服侍好多好多年了。我们从学青，我们那时候还在大一的时候就一起服侍，他现在都已经42岁了，我们还在一起。没有，那我们也是，我们已经一起服侍好久。那 for this illustration，其实我很有福分能够跟Miles一起服侍。那 for this illustration，in order to see what's going on between the relationships of the brothers, okay? We're gonna simulate the womb experience. 就是我们两个在母腹当中的感觉会是怎么样, okay? 所以呢, Isaac他们没有小孩子, are we recording this again? Okay, Isaac他没有小孩子, 对不对? Rebecca也不能生育, 所以 Isaac prayed to God. So Rebecca became pregnant. Now you have to imagine, we are now in the stomach of Rebecca, okay? Now, you can be the hairy one, and I will be the deceiver, okay? 这两个都不是一个很赞的一个, okay? 那我们在, so we are in the womb, 然后这旁边都是水, 我们有点是在游泳, okay? 那我们在母腹当中呢, 我们就开始打架了, okay? 所以呢, 你想那边是出口, OK， 那我们两个要争出谁可以先出来 ，OK， 那先出来的就当大哥，那比较晚出来的就要当弟弟，对不对？所以呢，我们就一直打，然后呢，我就要打过来的时候，来，我需要把脐带这样用过来，然后继续打，对不对？然后就打，然后他也会轻轻的打我，他会轻轻的打我，对不对？那 Rebecca 在上面，他就是 怎么了，对不对 ？OK， imagine X 是单位，所以 Rebecca 是单位 ，OK， 所以我们两个继续打，结果刚好要出生的那一天。 我的脐带才过来，刚好他比较靠近出口，所以呢，他就出去了 ，OK？ 可是等等，这是很慢的一个 process， 羊水要先破，然后水就出去了，然后你可以慢慢的出去 ，OK？ 那他出去的时候，我不想让他出去，因为我也要当哥哥，对不对？我们就是一直在争斗，我不想让他，可是我就抓着他的脚，我说你不要出去，你让我。
你知道我，可是我没办法，因为他比我太 hairy， 他有点 slippery， 所以他就出去了。好，谢谢，谢谢我们。所以在母父当中，他们就是这样子的 relationship， 他们就打架，然后 try to fight who gets to get out first， and it just so happens 在生小孩那一天刚好他比较站外面嘛， OK， 就 that's just reality。但是 Jacob 他很不认输，他的名字就叫 the deceiver， 就是骗人家的那个，就是 literally， 因为 the Hebrew word for Jacob it sounds like heel， 就是你的脚踝后面， so 所以他们才会说就是叫他 Jacob the deceiver， or his name actually means heel， which also means deceiver， 就是基本上就是扯人家后腿的意思， literally， right？ 所以就是他扯人家后腿，所以他叫 Jacob。 那当那一天他的哥哥 Esau 要出去的时候，他就是抓着他， even at that moment he was grabbing on， he was very competitiveIn that. And this would be a foreshadowing of their entire relationship. 成长的过程，他们家中的 dynamic 都会是 based on this. 他试着在 deceive 他哥哥，抓住他哥哥，想要 eat this. If you would follow along with me. Verse 27. The boys grew up. Now that's questionable, right?The boys grew up, verse 27, and Esau became a skillful hunter, a man of the open country, while Jacob was a quiet man, staying among the tents. Isaac, verse 28, who had a taste for wild game, loved Esau, but Rebekah loved Jacob. 所以他当长大了之后 naturally, because of his hairy fur or something, 他很喜欢打猎，所以他就喜欢出去然后开始打猎。可是另外一个 Jacob was not the same. Jacob likes indoors, 比较宅一点点，他喜欢在家里面，他喜欢 in fact, we know later on, he was cooking, and 他是比较喜欢那种 homey. And so, naturally, the one who stays at home develops a deeper relationship with the mom, whereas the other one who goes hunting deers and pigs and cows and whatever, right, brings home these big animals, roast them up, had the favor of the father, 因为爸爸喜欢吃，所以 it became very, very, very different. But mind you, we know twins.Are supposed to be very similar in many ways. 他们 I'm fascinated with twins. 就是他们长得很像，然后有时候我跟他们讲话的时候，觉得哦，你到底是谁，对不对 ？OK. Now, I mean, we have twins here. Okay. Now, supposedly there's a lot of similarities, but the Bible doesn't talk about their similarities. The Bible 从他们出生就讲他们是有多不一样。How different they are. 一个很 hairy， 本来一出来就叫他 you know, Esau.然后另外一个是 Deceiver， 他的个性其实是很喜欢扯人家后腿、欺负人家。然后他们长大的时候，一个喜欢打猎，一个喜欢 hunt animals and the open country outdoor 的东西，一个喜欢待在家里面煮东西，然后看书。I don't know what he does, right? 就待在家里面。And so the Bible shows how different they are. And verse 28.Would you follow along with me one more time? Verse 28, Isaac, who had a taste for wild game, loved Esau, but Rebekah loved Jacob. 这句话好像我们可以很快的读过去，可是其实它的 implication 很深。Basically, 他们 have favoritisms. The dad loves the son more because this is what a man is supposed to be like. He's the elder. He goes out hunting. This is my child. Yeah, this is the man. He hunts. He kills animals.And while the other, 这个孩子好贴心，可以陪我去煮菜、煮红豆汤，等等的，他喜欢待在家，他不喜欢都是跑哦，好乖哦。所以 it became a favoritism. 爸爸喜欢 Esau， 妈妈喜欢弟弟 Jacob. And 这样读过去很快，可是 but in two chapters, their favoritism would actually tear this family apart. I say again, their favoritism, 他们的偏心 would actually tear this family apart.Follow along with me. Verse 29. Once when Jacob was cooking some stew, Esau came in from the open country, famished. He said to Jacob, Quick,
Let me have some of that red stew, 就是红豆汤。I am famished. That is, he was about, that is why he was called Edom, which means red.
所以其实他哥哥很惨的，他哥哥一直在被叫红色，很多毛，红色。OK，
那第三十一节 ，Jacob replied, first, sell me your birthright. 三十二节 ，Look, I'm about to die. Esau said, what good is the birthright to me? 三十三节 ，But Jacob said, swear to me first. So he swore an oath to him, selling his birthright to Jacob.
I don't know why Esau did that. I don't know why Esau felt the compulsion to sell his birthright for a bowl of soup.
他出去打猎，可能打猎打了很久，
然后可能有 drag animal, but I don't know what it is. But apparently, he did not prepare enough food or water or something for himself.So he pushed himself to the limit, and when he comes back to the house, apparently he faces his brother and goes, "You're cooking some of that stew. Give me your stew, because if I don't drink of that stew, I'm gonna die." Now he was either in a very desperate place, or he just really loves that stew, or just wants to drink, right? Now he says, "Give me some of that stew," and Jacob would not. See, Jacob, 有一点点。Kind of he is a deceiver in many ways. He is trying to take advantage of the situation like any good businessman would, right? He is trying to say, okay, I do have a bowl of soup, but if I can turn this bowl of soup into birthright, that is everything, wow, that would be awesome. 他看到他哥哥隐匿, rather than having compassion, he sells the stew for the birthright.
I think that's a pretty good deal on Jacob's part. But on Esau's part, I'm about to die, 我要死了。
Birthright 有什么?
But in reality, birthright meant a lot. He is the elder, and when his father dies, he actually inherits much, much more than Jacob. Inherit much, much more because he is the elder son. The Jewish tradition had that he inherited三分之二 of all the inheritance of the father's family. 三分之二 But now it's changed. I mean, that's a lot of money. You remember, Abraham was really well off. So all that Abraham was did not pass on to any of the maidservant sons. All that Abraham had went to Isaac. And when Isaac dies, all that Isaac had is going to go to a son. And they're going to split it. Okay? But Jacob took it. Jacob took it with a bowl of soup.He's very, very smart. Very smart. 那在这边 why did Esau lightly see this thing? Why did Esau lightly? Because I believe there are issues there that only is present later on. 他对他的家庭感觉有一种 discontent. He was not fully satisfied with the family that he has. In fact, you'll see it in chapter 26. That is, Isaac did a lot of things.That make the kids really hard to respect him. And so Esau simply didn't care about his birthright, 他就把他卖掉了。而且你注意哦，第三十一节 Jacob replied, first sell me your birthright. You see that first? Some of our translation has sell me your birthright now. 那个字 in Hebrew could be translated first or right now.说你要喝红汤吗？你先把你的这个你的 birthright 卖给我 ，right now， 现在就卖给我。In fact， 他又再问一次，第三十二节 ，Look， I'm about to die. Esau said, "What good is my birthright to me?" 三十三节 ，Jacob said, "Swear to me first," or another translation, "Swear to me right now." 你先不要喝我的汤，你先不要喝我的汤，你先跟我发誓。He knows that he's trying to use this as a leverage against his brother, which is almost twisted and sick.But he is doing this to his brothers to gain what he wanted. So in this matter, he wins. 第三十四节 Then Jacob gave Esau some bread and some lentil stew. He ate and drank. See, bread wasn't part of the deal, so he was kind of generous for all the inheritance he's going to get, right? He ate and drank, and then got up and left.
So Esau despised his birthright. He just didn't care for what his family had to. Chapter 29, we're going to go through some of it. And next week, when I preach, I'm going to finish off chapter 26. Okay, so we're going to go through it a little bit, and this is only half the story. Chapter 26, verse 1. Now there was a famine in the land, besides the earlier famine of Abraham's time. And Isaac went to Abimelech, king of the Philistines, in Gerar. Verse 2. The Lord appeared to Isaac and said, do not go down to Egypt, but live in this land, where I tell you to live. Verse 3. Stay in this land for a while, and I will be with you and will bless you. For to you and your descendants, I will give all these land. Remind you this. All these land. And will confirm the oath I have swear to your father Abraham. Verse 4. I will make your descendants as numerous as the star in the sky, and will give them all these land. And though your offsprings and your offsprings, all nations on the earth will be blessed. Verse 5. Because Abraham obeyed me and kept my requirements, my commands, my decrees, my laws. Verse 6. So Isaac stayed in Gerar. What happened to the family was, after the initial birth of the two kids, and they're fighting even since the womb, and even at the birth, even as they grow up, their fighting was constant. But the story shifts a little bit. It shifts to Isaac having to move the whole family to Gerar. They had to uproot everything and move to this land, the land where the Philistines are now in control. So when the famine happened, it forced them to move. 其实在这个当中呢，其实我们看到很多生命的道理是说， 上帝有时候会 push us， 用一些 circumstance to push us， 不管是 move our entire family， 或者是 move us temporarily， or move our relationship， move our everything， God can use circumstances to push us out of our comfort zone。 但在这些 comfort zone 的时候呢，你会发现这个家庭 as well as our home。 当我们在 when we're encountering these changes, these moves, it really shows us who we are. 当有这种变动的时候，我们的心真正是谁 被 revealed. We reveal who we are when there are changes in our lives. And God used this to show us who Isaac is. Because what Isaac is going to do in chapter 26 will influence the kids. Hugely influence the kids. Would you follow along with me? And by the way, they're in the land that God has promised for them. This is their land that God has promised. Verse 7. When the man of that place, the Philistines, asked him about his wife, he said, she is my sister, because he was afraid to say, she is my wife. He thought, the man of this place might kill me on account of Rebekah, because she is beautiful. Okay, 最好有这么漂亮，OK？我，哇，I don't know，他已经六十岁了，最好有这么漂亮。但是他们搬到这个地方的时候， I don't know why， 就是非常漂亮。然后那边的人想要他的太太，But he is very afraid that 这些人会因为他的太太杀死他，把他所有都抢走，然后抢走他太太，因为他太太的关系，OK？ 所以他说，他不是我太太，他是我妹妹。 那这个有谁之前做过这招了？在圣经里面，我不是说你们，我说是圣经里面，就是在圣经里面，有谁已经做过这招了？他爸爸亚伯拉罕，他爸爸亚伯拉罕不是做一次哦，他爸爸亚伯拉罕做了两次 the same trick， 他 Abraham took his wife to the location， 然后他怕他太太太漂亮，对不对？他就说哇，是我妹妹。 结果就他太太就被抓走了，送完收获，然后一大堆的，对不对？然后后来上帝救他们出那个 situation， 他到下一个 location， 过了好多年，他又做一次，他到 Abimelech 那个王，然后 Abraham 又说 ，It's my sister， not my wife，OK？ 所以他连续做了两次这样子的 situation。 Now I don't know how this happened。 Abraham 在做两次这样的事情的时候 ，That is he disowned his wife twice 的时候 ，Isaac 根本还没出生。 Okay, I'm going to say it again. Both times that Abraham disowned his wife, that is, lied about his wife's status as that she's not my wife, she's my sister. Both times, Isaac wasn't even born yet. So how did Isaac pick up the same thing? How did Isaac learn this trick?
无形之中，我在读大学的时候，有一个我那一堂课叫犯罪心理学，然后呢，我那个教授他其实他在讲那个 heritage， 他说 heritage is powerful， 就是 things， 他就讲说有他有一个 son， 他是一个我的教授他是一个墨西哥人，然后他头发黑黑的，然后他喜欢留小胡子，然后呢他就说我的小孩子呢，他 he's a teenager now， at high school， and one time as my professor he was walking by the bathroom, he saw the bathroom door was open, he saw his son shaving. Now you have to understand, well, the professor, because he has to shave, because he's a man hairy man, he said his technique is he filled up the bowl, the professor himself filled up the bowl, the sink with water, stop it so that it's full of water, puts that thing on, right, the foam on, and shaves it twice, dips it in water, hit it on the side twice. This is his technique, okay? Shave it twice, rinse it, hit it twice on the sink. That is the way that he always done it, the way. 所以他以为是他经过他儿子的那个，他儿子在那边 shaving， 然后 put it on the stop and one， 然后 shaves it twice, put it in the water, rinse it, hits it twice.然后 shaves twice, rinse it in the water, hits it twice. 我的 professor 就好 proud. 我说 Oh, that's my son. He does the same thing I do. I mean, these little things, he's learning from me. I influence him well. 结果呢，哪知道他们有一次 retreat 的时候，就是他们家就回到这个我 professor 的爸爸家。他经过他爸爸的时候，看到他爸爸 shaves twice, rinse it, hit it on the side twice. 然后他心里就整个震撼。I never learned that from my father. I thought I invented that technique. I thought I did it. 结果他无形之中 pick it up from his father. 他以为他小孩子也是 develop that technique. No, 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 他小孩子也是跟他学的。These things, whether we like it or not, what Abraham did, 自然而然就到他的孩子身上。Because of the way that he acts, the way that he speaks, the way that his demeanor when he faces pressure. When Isaac,had to move to this location, he was facing all sorts of pressure. And when pressure strikes him, he reacts the same way his father did, in line. Now, real quick survey, okay? 所以这边的姐妹们，其实长辈们、阿姨们， okay? 或是刚结婚的，如果说你已经结婚了， okay? 然后呢，你的先生， okay, already? 你的先生说，你们到了一个地方，然后呢，他说谎，就是很多人在问。然后呢 ，at a party。Okay. 然后很多人会说，哦，这位女士是，然后你的先生说，哦，她是我妹妹，她不是我太太。OK， 这边有姐妹会很高兴的，请举手。哦，没有啊。这边有姐妹回去会有一个 serious conversation with the husband 的，请举手。OK， 邀请。OK， so obviously that's a huge problem. So that was what he was going through. 可是这个情况其实很尴尬。Let's go for a little bit and more end. Verse 8.When Isaac had been there for a long time, Abimelech, king of the Philistines, looked down from a window and saw Isaac caressing his wife, Rebekah. 所以他们两个在亲热 ,OK? Isaac 跟他太太在亲热，结果被那个王看到。第九节 ,So, Abimelech summoned Isaac and said, She is really your wife. Why did you say she is my sister? Isaac answered, Because I thought I might lose my life on account of her. 所以在这边 I don't know how that happened, 就是Isaac 跟他太太就在已经坐在那边很久，然后他们两个就抱啊，然后做大人做的事情嘛，对不对？然后在这边这个王 somehow 他的 palace location looks down at 这些人的家，那他们两个亲热就刚好被这个王看到，对不对？这个王就看到他们两个亲热，那这个王你在想哦，这是 a shock to the king。对啊，这个以色列人搬来这边，他说他是他的妹妹。可是为什么他们两个在抱抱，然后又亲？哦，以色列是这样子的吗？啊，哦，等一下，他们不是兄妹吗？怎么在做这种事情？然后他们就 figure out， 这个王就 figure out， 哦，原来这个不正常，原来 Isaac 骗这个王，所以这个王才不生气。I don't have too much time to go forward, but keep in mind this.All that Isaac was doing
他的小孩子都看在眼中。You have to understand, this passage is more about the kids and parenting than anything else. 所有 Isaac 和 Rebecca 在做的，他的小孩子都看在眼中。如当 Isaac 说 ，Rebecca, you are my sister now. Jacob and Esau 要叫 Rebecca 什么？阿姨。所以 while the whole time that they're living in this location, 而且甚至说他们住在那边很久。Jacob and Esau 都要叫他妈妈 in public, 阿姨。Would that not mess up your childhood? 叫你妈妈阿姨 for very many, many years. And to lie about your mom's identity. And when you know this is dishonest, when you know your father's telling a lie and you have to play part in that lie. This is the kind of messed up family that Jacob grew up under. This is the kind of messed up family that Esau grew up under.Call the mom, auntie. I don't have time to finish this chapter as well as the next, but I'll finish it next week. But I think so far we can learn many, many things. That yes, God is in control and God knows the future, but at the same time, the influences of the family is tremendous. Kids pick up stuff from parents so easily, whether they like it or not, they just pick it up.Abraham was a liar about his wife. Isaac became a liar about his wife. And Jacob took it to the next step. And the family is not perfect at all. But God was in the midst of that. That makes me really fearful about everything that I do. And especially about serving God in a spiritual family. So, before we end, I just want to pray for all of us, and next week we get to finish the story. But let us pray together. Father, your word is so real and it's so convicting. Father, some of us grew up in that environment and we were really messed up by the family, whether we like it or not. Father, would you help us in that? Would you help us in that?Father, some of us are hurt and pain and bruised so bad from our family that it messes us up in every aspect, every facet of our lives. Would you heal us and would you guide us? Father, some of us are influencing others. Would you help us to be good influences? Father, would you tug on our hearts and help us, hold us accountable?Father, we love you, and would you continue to be with us, and would you let the story of Isaac and Rebecca, Jacob and Esau be a great reminder to us of what is not pleasing to you and of what is pleasing to you. Thank you, Lord. Be with us. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Now, if today you need prayer for anything, it could be anything. It could be your family, it could be you, it could be anything. Our prayer team will be up in the front here.I would love to pray for you. Or if you don't feel comfortable in coming up and letting us pray for you, write, there's a sheet in front of you. If you write down your prayer request, our prayer team will pray for you. We will pray for you. And we need to have a prayer support. So, our service officially concludes now. Let us leave this congregation for worship. If you need to talk, we can do so outside.